Like all the other game maps, the upcoming Tower Fall DLC map has a lot of rocks in it. But what kinds of rocks? That's always the interesting question. At least it's interesting to me and maybe 5 or 6 other players out there. So for the enjoyment of the 7 of us, we're going to look at the geology of the Tower Fall map today and how we're recreating it in the game. Right here, for example, this spot is known as the Overhanging Cliff, just north of the Tower Fall waterfall. And it is an overhanging cliff, but it's actually more notable for these basalt columns. 2 million years ago, eruptions in the vast Yellowstone volcanic field to the south of here sent lava flowing in every direction, and right along here, where the lava slowly cooled, it contracted. Kind of like how drying mud contracts and cracks. Here the cracks went down vertically and formed these oddly geometric columns. There are similar formations just across the Yellowstone River from here. Those are formed from different eruptions 1.3 million years ago. So that's in the corner of the map, but kind of a neat spot. But this whole area has a volcanic history due to the presence of Mount Washburn, an ancient volcano at the south edge of the map. Washburn erupted about 640,000 years ago, spewing lava and ash all around. Some of the lava cooled quickly and formed blocky rocks called breccia. So up at the high elevations of the map, the terrain is blanketed with these dark, angular rocks and grass and trees growing where they can. In terms of game production, though, creating this kind of landscape has been difficult. The terrain textures can't render that kind of bumpiness, especially sharp bumpiness, without a special technique called tessellation. It has a big performance impact. We use it for the deep snow trenches, but it's prohibitive to use it throughout the map for this kind of thing. But I'm experimenting now with using the blanket shader, that thing that we're now using for the large grass patches. You might recall how this shader wraps the mesh to the terrain surface. And that's just what we need for these large breccia fields. I really like how this looks. Currently wrangling with a couple of rendering bugs. Hope to get those resolved so we can really use this. Okay, switching back to the geology. Many of these breccia rocks came to rest on the upper surfaces of the mountain here, but a lot of them got caught up in mud flows and landslides, which carried them farther downhill before cooling off. When they cooled, those formed conglomerate rocks. Really just means it's a conglomeration. It's a combination of a wide variety of small rocks and mud and whatever the mudslide picked up along the way. These are distributed maybe overall a little lower elevation than the breccia, but still up on the slopes of the mountain. But the volcano also spewed out clouds of volcanic ash, which drifted away before settling onto the ground. But when it settled, it was still so hot, over 600 degrees Celsius, that the ash welded together, creating large areas of what's called welded ash, or tuff, T-U-F-F. And it is actually also pretty tough. Takes a lot to erode it, but that means you can get some pretty amazing rock formations like the Devil's Den here, just above the Tower Fall waterfall, where Tower Creek has, over many, many years, eroded these fantastic spires and pinnacles and hoodoos. So then after these volcanic eruptions, many millennia later, the glaciers moved in repeatedly, scouring the landscape, and then as they receded, leaving behind a layer of glacial till. All kinds of sediment, clay, silt, sand, pebbles, rocks, and boulders. And these glacial erratics, these boulders, which you also see in other maps. And they carved out a few of these kettles, glacial ponds. So that means that much of the game map is a pretty gentle landscape. These rolling hills and ravines in the Antelope Creek watershed, where the glaciers scoured the land and then filled it with gravel. All this makes the Tower Fall map quite different from the granite landscapes of Slough Creek and Hell Roaring Mountain. It's much more similar to Amethyst Mountain, with the chunky, bumpy conglomerate rock formations and broad valleys and plateaus that are layered with glacial till. The only really big feature here, besides Mount Washburn itself, is the Grand Canyon of the Yellowstone River, which cuts through various kinds of rock formations as it meanders north. Along here, I think it's volcanic tuff, and so it's eroded into this very steep-walled section of canyon. But that's mainly down here in the southeast corner. Further downstream, it's glacial till, which has eroded into more gentle canyon walls, so you can avoid this area down here if you don't like this kind of thing. So as you can see, Tower Fall is coming along. Didn't get a lot of work done over the summer because of all the other things we were doing, but making progress now. Gotta tackle the dens, and we'll have more devblogs about that kind of thing later this year, so stay tuned.